Hello children, how are you? Today I am continuing 8th class mathematics. I hope you all understood the previous videos. Today we are going to start a new topic, that is representation of rational numbers on a number line. Representation of rational numbers on a number line. Before we start this, you all know that how to represent natural numbers, whole numbers and integers on the number line. That we learned in the previous class. That we will see once. So how to represent natural numbers on the number line? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and so on. So these arrow marks represent that they are increasing, they are infinity. You can take how many ever you want on the number line. Next, to represent whole numbers on the number line, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7 and so on. And how to represent integers on the number line? So you all know that integers means the combination of whole numbers and negative numbers. So middle you get 0, that is neither positive nor negative, and right side of that you get all positive integers, and left side of this you get all negative integers. So this is the representation of natural numbers on the number line, representation of whole numbers on the number line, integers on the number line. Now we are going to represent rational numbers on the number line. We will represent, now you all know that the rational numbers are in the form of p by q. So first we will represent 5 by 8 on the number line. So what do you mean by 5 by 8? It is a proper fraction. The numerator is less than the denominator. That means the fraction lies between 0 and 1. So how this can be represented on the number line? So this is 0 and this is 1. So you take 1 by 8, 2 by 8, 3 by 8, 4 by 8 and 5 by 8. So if you want, you can take 6 by 8, 7 by 8 and 8 by 8 equal to 1. So representation of a proper fraction, that is 5 by 8 on the number line. So proper fractions all lies between 0 and 1. That's why this is represented in between 0 and 1. Now we represent one more fraction, that is rational number 29 by 6. So what type of fraction it is? It's not a proper fraction, it is an improper fraction. So change this fraction into a mixed fraction. How we will look by division, that is 6, 4, 24, 9 minus 4 is 5. So this can be written as 4, 5 by 6. Therefore 29 by 6 is lies between 4 and 5. So how we represent this on number line? So take here 4 and here it is 5. And what fraction you got? 5 by 6. So 1 by 6, 2 by 6, 3 by 6, 4 by 6, 5 by 6. Therefore, this is equal to 4, 5 by 6 and is equal to 29 by 6. So all improper fractions we have to represent like this only. First change that in the form of a mixed fraction and you can represent. Next we will represent a negative rational number, that is minus 13 by 5. Minus 13 by 5. So it is also a improper fraction. Change this into mixed fraction, 13 by 5. So how many times? 5, 2 are 10. And this is 3. This can be written in the form of minus 2, 3 by 5. So where it lies between? It lies between minus 2 and minus 1. So we have to go to negative side, no need of the positive side. Minus 1 and it lies between minus 2. Minus 1, minus 2, minus 3. So minus 2, 1 by 5, 2 by 5, 3 by 5 and so on. So all these are negative values. Okay, and go on and so on, it will come minus. So this is the way to represent rational numbers on the number line. You take some examples and write by your own. Now we'll see rational numbers between rational numbers. Rational numbers between rational numbers. So before we go to this, can you tell what are the numbers lies between 1 and 5? What are the natural numbers between 1 and 5? We know we can easily say that is 2, 3 and 4. What are the integers between minus 4 and 2? Can anyone say? Yes. Minus 3, minus 2, minus 1, 0 and 1. Can you tell what are the integers lies between minus 2 and minus 1? We can't say because there are no integers between minus 2 and minus 1. But we can insert infinitely many rational numbers between two rational numbers by two methods. The first one is mean method and the second one is making the denominator equal. Making the denominator equal. So first we'll see the mean method. Insert example, insert rational number between 2 and 3. 2 and 3 are the rational numbers. Yes, by writing 1 as a denominator, they are the rational numbers. So how you insert the rational number between 2 and 3 by mean method? You know all of you what you mean by mean method. If A equals to 2 and B equals to 3, so the rational number between 2 and 3 can be done by A plus B by 2. This is called as a mean method. Sum of the observations by number of observations. So what will you get here? This is 2 plus 3 by 2, which is equal to 5 by 2. So how we can represent that on number line? 2, 5 by 2 and 3. Again, if you want to insert a rational number between 2 and 5 by 2, we have to insert. That is also by using the mean method, that is A plus B by 2. We'll see now how it is. So here now A value is 2. B value is 5 by 2. So how we find by using a mean method? A plus B by 2. What is A value here? 2 plus 5 by 2 by 2. Again these 2 also will come here. So here it is, LCM is 1. 1 2 jar 2. LCM is 2. 1 2 jar 2. 2 2 jar 4. Plus 2 1 jar 2. 5 1 jar 5. By 2 by 2. So this is equals to 4 plus 5, 9 by 2 by 2. We all know that the fraction divided by fraction gives the reciprocal of the down fraction, that is 1 by 2. So which is equals to 9 by 4. So this value will be equal to, that means you got a rational number between 2 and 5 by 2 is 9 by 4. Like this we can insert infinitely many rational numbers between two rational numbers by mean method. But it is little bit difficult to insert because always you have to find the LCM and fraction dividing the values. It takes some more time. So the easy method you are having is by making the denominator same. Now tell me, can you insert 100 rational numbers between 5 by 10 and 9 by 10? How many numbers you will get between 5 by 10 and 9 by 10? So you will get 6 by 10, 7 by 10, 8 by 10. Is it possible now 100 rational numbers? No. Only 3 rational numbers are sitting here. So just you make the denominator and numerator by multiplying with 10. This becomes 50 by 100. And same 9 by 10. Numerator into 10 and denominator into 10, this is 90 by 100. So how many rational numbers you will get between 50 by 100 and 90 by 100? Here also you won't get 100. You are getting only 40. So again what to do? Again multiply this into 10 and this into 10. This into 10 and this into 10. So what will you get? This is 500 by 1000 and 900 by 1000. So how many rational numbers you can insert here? You can insert only 400 rational numbers here. So like this, you can make the denominator equal by multiplying with whatever number you want according to the fractions, and you can insert as many rational numbers as you want. We'll see now a small example. Insert a five rational numbers between -3 and 0. Are they rational numbers? Yes. By writing 1 as a denominator. So how many numbers you will get between -3 and 0? You get only -2, -1. Only 2 you are getting. But I am asking you insert 5 rational numbers between -3 and 0. So you just write the denominator as 1 and multiply both the numerator and denominator with 10. So you will get this is -30 by 10. 0 by 1, 1 into 10, 0 into 10, this is equals to 0 by 10. So, how many numbers you will get between -30 by 10 and 0 by 10? You will get many numbers, that is -29 by 10, -28 by 10, -27 by 10, -26 by 10, -25 by 10, -24 by 10, and so on. So I told you I want only 5 rational numbers. So can I take this? So these are the 5 rational numbers between -3 and 0. I hope you all understood rational numbers representation on the number line and rational numbers between 2 rational numbers by mean method and by making the denominator same. We'll see the exercise in the next class. Have a good day.